In the last video, we had successfully trained an XOR based model. Now is the time to make an API or deploy the model to production. So let's start. Before we start, don't be scared by looking at the code. It's a fairly simple code. I'll guide you through each part of the code. So let's start. Firstly, you'll need a library called Flask. You can basically install Flask by typing in pip install flask in your Ubuntu terminals or even in your command prompt in Windows. You can basically go on to install Flask. There are many tutorials that you'll find on how to install Flask, so you can just Google that out. You create an instance of the class Flask. After you create an instance, you first create an index or the first default root for your API if nothing's basically mentioned. So what I'm doing is my default, as soon as I start my server and when I deploy this, it should basically, if I hit this API without passing in any parameters, it should return XOR prediction. If you pass in parameters which are wrong, then you have to have a try catch, which I have taken care in the next part. Now you create one more root for your Flask application and you name it as XOR prediction. And for XOR predictions, again, you will need two inputs, 0 or 1, x1 or x2. So the method you get in the parameters are get and post. So for get, what happens is all your parameters that you pass are written into the into your HTTP request itself. Everything's visible as an HTTP request, whereas in post, it's kind of hidden inside the HTTP body. So you don't have to display all your parameter values in your post request. I've chosen get for the simplicity of making a simple tutorial out. Then you create a function which would extract out the body and header. Now your parameters would basically lie in your header body. So what you do is you extract the numbers x1 and x from fields x1 and x2, convert them to an integer form. And since you are checking if the two numbers are binary as well as they are not none, if this condition is satisfied, then you go on to make a prediction from your model. So coming to this function, it's a fairly simple function. You go to this part of your code, you input the two numbers, you have a dictionary. The reason why I'm taking a dictionary here is because eventually you want to output it in a form of a JSON response, which is more of a dictionary-like format, which can be then accessed by someone using Java or any other language as well. So your output should be a form of a dictionary kind of a thing. So it is easy for that to basically become a JSON format. Then you take in the input that you have inputted from your HTTP request, num1 and num2, reshape that array into a form of one row and two columns. Load your pickle file. So since I wanted to make this example really simple, I didn't load the pickle file name as form of a request, but you can do that as well. You load it using pickle.load format function. Then you update the dictionary which you have initially set to 0 based on your model prediction value. You then return the output. So your output that is returned is saved in this result. And in the end, you basically return the JSONified version of your result. If either of your numbers are not inputted properly, you'll get this message that your API hit was false and your inputted data was not correct. If there's some other error that happens, if you're not able to extract both the numbers, then you will have this error populated that it's not a successful API hit and your error is unknown. And there's one more thing to note here in the bottom most part of the screen. As you can see, you have to start your server or your API. So what you have to do is you have, by default, it's 4 8s, if I'm not wrong. I may be wrong here, but then by default, if you don't specify the port, your localhost 8888 port would be accessed. But I want a different port to be accessed for this API. So I define 8791 port. Now things are done. I'll give you a demo as to how things are now gonna work in form of a deployed API. I first check if my pickle file is there. Yes, it's there. So now I type Python XOR train dot py. API dot py. Now you'll get something of this sort. So now your server is active. Now all you have to do is hit the API with the correct x1 and x2 parameters to get the output. I'll show you. So this is your localhost IP address 127.0.0.1 with your port number as 8791. I hit that and you get the default page prediction that comes up as XOR prediction. Now the next step that I do is I call the function XOR prediction and I put a question mark and I input the values x1 equal to 0 and x2 equal to 0. Now if you see for 0 and 0, the output prediction, the format is also displayed as JSON, is 0. Next case we look at x01. Now you get the output as 1. Now I say x1 is 1, x2 is 0. Your output is again 1, and for 11 it should be 0, which it is. So our API is doing a really good job. Now what you can do is your API can be hit and you can extract this JSON response out of your model. So this video clearly demonstrates how you can easily build a model using scikit-learn. Post that you can save your model as a pickle file, and using Flask and a very simple API call, you can build a model which can you can build an API which can be used for deploying. And yeah, that's about it. If you just want to see the error case as well, if I say x2 equal to 5 now, so it basically says inputted data is not correct. So our API is performing reasonably well for this particular use case. You can play around with things and explore more. I hope you found this video tutorial really helpful. If there is anything that you want me to share across, if you have queries regarding any topic in machine learning, feel free to reach out to me. I'll be posting the code shortly on GitHub, so you can have access to the code as well. Hope you enjoyed the videos. Thank you.